That looks a good decision.
Matching the ties very well at the moment. They're still losing a few, mind you, but outside of Thailand, I think Holland is doing very well. France, England, but Europe now really are impressing in the Thai boxing world.
There's the tail of the tape on Rasmussen, 25 years old, a winner of 14 of his 19 contests. And here's Peter Hopkins, the European champion, now 26 years old, he's won 18 of 21. We're not seeing any ties on the bill tonight, but of course, in general, and this is a generalisation, a good Thai fighter you would still expect to be the good European fighter by and large, wouldn't you?
Yes, most of the time. If you was down at the bookmakers, well, you won't find me, but I think you find the money's usually on the ties, because at the end of the day, it's been around over 2,000 years, it's the national heritage, and there's thousands of people, it's an actual national sport of Thailand, and just like we're kicking a football in the streets over here, they're kicking each other over there in Thailand.
Is there a sense of national pride with the Thais that they don't like to lose to European fighters? I mean, is it a bit of a front to the national image?
Yes, very much so. They feel a little bit disgraced or perhaps dishonoured if they lose against somebody else who actually is their national sport, for somebody else to come and take it from them. They don't like it and they will always look for a return match.
Well, you've got to be pretty good to beat a Thai fighter, but it does happen, of course. And Peter Hopkins is certainly one man that could be expected to give most Thai fighters a pretty good run for their money. So this... Well, there is no main event as such, but for us, we think this is certainly the pick of the fight. Peter Hopkins, the European champion, against the man from Harfala in Sweden, Thomas Rasmussen. There he is, Rasmussen in the silver, fighting out of the blue corner. Hopkins is in a sort of maroon out of the red corner. And again, we've said it before about our first two fights, but again, on paper, this one looks a very tough one to call, doesn't it?
Certainly does.
Hopkins, the European champion, his title not at stake tonight. But obviously it would do Rasmussen's prospect no harm at all if he could claim the scalp of Peter Hopkins here.
Round one.
5 2-minute rounds as usual. John Blackley's the third man in the ring. And we're underway.
Very relaxed start. Both fighters looking for an opening, and there was one almost made there with a good high kick from Peter.
Rasmussen moved out of the way fast enough. Hopkins landed on thin air. But I don't expect he's going to stay that way for too long. Combination there from the Swede, moved in, did his work, and got out of range again. Early days, but the Swede's defensive technique seems pretty sound, Sandy.
Yes, Peter testing a little bit, but Thomas is there.
Rasmussen aims the high kick and slips over. So the countdown begins now, last 20 seconds of this opening session. A very quiet opening round indeed. So the bell goes to end a fairly quiet opening session. Now we know about Hopkins, of course, so let's talk about Thomas Rasmussen. He seemed a fairly accomplished fighter from what we saw of him in those first two minutes.
Yes, I actually watched Thomas Rasmussen in Holland a few years ago, so he's been around on the circuit probably as long as Mr. Hopkins as well, and very confident. In fact, in that last round he was taunting a little bit to Peter, just showing his face, showing his chin, which isn't a wise thing to do with such a formidable opponent in front of your face. But, yes, very much like a chess match, that first opening round.
Yes, a risky game from Rasmussen, but I think Rasmussen probably got the best kick of that first round. We're just going to see it now. Not much action in the first round, but that certainly woke up Peter Hopkins. If he'd gone in there expecting an easy night's work, that let him know he wasn't going to get it.
That's right. Good job. His hand was there. Just took it on the top of the glove.
So the first round, fairly quiet. Honours probably pretty much even. Very little to choose between them there. But four rounds to go. We're underway with round two. Rasmussen trying to get the knees to the midsection going and having some success. Not quite as much as he'd like, perhaps. But this certainly a very bright start for the man from Sweden. Hopkins not yet in top gear, really.
Referee doing very well there, to knowing when to break the fighters, which is important, because a referee who can be too late or too soon can upset the flow of the fighter's rhythm.
So we're into the second minute of this second round. That was a good kick to the thigh there from Hopkins. And another one. Rasmussen comes right back at him. Well, I'm sure Thomas Rasmussen wasn't overawed when he got into the ring with Peter Hopkins. But he certainly, whatever else he's seen in this opening 3.5 minutes, he's realised that Peter Hopkins can be beaten. Hopkins not making the brightest of starts here. Hopkins, of course, the European champion. We'd expect him to win this fight. And he's taking it very slowly indeed against a very experienced and tough man from Sweden.
Seems quite strong actually in the clinch work. I find with all these Scandinavian fighters, the Swedish, the Finnish, they've actually, a lot of these, Nick, have trained in Thailand, and they don't just go for a holiday. They're out there for 3 months at a time. They do train very seriously over there.
Each man just acknowledging the other's efforts there at the end of that second round. I don't think there's any needle here. Like you, Sandy, I saw what looked like a little bit of taunting going on in that first round, but there seems to be a bit of respect there now after that second round.
Most definitely. But, yeah, they were saying the fighter there, Thomas Rasmussen, against this fighter, Peter Hopkins, he's obviously done his homework. He knows who his opponent was, and he's obviously trained according to how he's going to fight this man.
Well, on my card, I've got Rasmussen slightly ahead at the moment, I have to say, after two rounds, which is a bit of a surprise. How have you seen it?
Exactly the same. First round, obviously, evens. The second round to Rasmussen.
Let me just see a bit of the inside work coming there. Rasmussen, when they get into a clinch, seems to want to be doing more work than Hopkins, which again has kind of taken, I think, this crowd a bit by surprise. It's Rasmussen that is attempting to dictate the pace of the contest so far.
Round three.
So the third round then. Peter Hopkins in the maroon against Thomas Rasmussen from Sweden in the silver. So the Swede has made a very encouraging start indeed, and again, they get into a clinch, and it's Rasmussen that is trying to do them all work.
This is very tiring, this, Mick. When any two fighters start getting involved with a lot of clinch work, you wouldn't believe how tiring it really is. Having been in the ring myself many times, it is really tiring, and they take a lot of stamina out of each fighter.
Hopkins loses his balance.
Knee is working very well for Thomas Rasmussen. Peter is obviously going to have to learn to combat this and try and fight at a longer range, because all the time he's in there, Rasmussen is scoring points.
Yeah, certainly Hopkins needs to keep it at a distance, because I think Rasmussen has worked out that when they get tied up together, it's Rasmussen that's coming off the better of the two. And again here in this third round, it's Rasmussen that's piling on the pressure, as we see his coach and second there urging him on. He must be very impressed with what he's seen so far.
Yes, Kai Mustonen there. He's obviously brought a good team of fighters over with him here tonight.
Well, they're one for one so far, the Scandinavian Raiders. Rasmussen so far is doing enough to make it two for two. Hopkins starting to get involved.